Hop in, babe. We're going.
Woohoo!
Well, your new friends from the Netherlands used to have a house left into the mud, but an old RV called Penelope. She's a 1983. Pictures and patterns of design. Penelope loves Rob until the end of time. Well, RVlicious, if you like a vibe, please subscribe. Please subscribe.
Making a little painting.
A turtle?
Yes.
Wow. What inspired you to do a turtle?
Guess what?
We visited the turtle sanctuary.
Yes.
Awesome. Is it a work in progress?
Yep. Work in progress. This is the base. And then the colors and the rest will... Next. So now it is to dry. And then we'll continue.
Wow. Hi, Betty.
Hello.
When we were at the turtle sanctuary, Gerard van der Wijk, who runs the place, he also gave us a prezi.
A prezi, yes.
And it's over there.
It's over there. Can you see what it is?
AGM 12 volts, 100 10 amp hours deep cycle battery. So that's really cool.
Super cool. Thank you.
Oh, thank you, Gerard. Mm-hmm. Now we have two options, and that is we want to try to change it out ourselves. We don't have much tools. Could ask Handy Herman, of course. Mm-hmm. But how difficult can it be? So this is the point, you know, that point that you say the wise thing would probably be to ask somebody to do it. Mm-hmm. But on the other hand, yeah, it would be fun if we would be able to do something technical or fixy-pixy on the van. So this is also the point that everything still works, that the van still starts, and
exactly.
Once you start fixing things, sometimes you wish afterwards you wouldn't have done it and wouldn't have touched it.
Yep.
So
exactly.
At that point we are now. But what do you say? Shall we give it a go? See how far we can come? Yeah, basically Herman measured our old battery and it was completely empty. So maybe it's just at the end of its cycle. So we want to try out and just connect everything on the battery from Gerard the way it is on the current battery. Mm-hmm. And in theory everything should work then.
Yes. Indeed.
Well, it would be nice to have working radio again and working lights in the mm-hmm. in the after season, because yep. everything is getting yeah. dark already.
Soon. Yes, very soon it's already getting dark. Mm-hmm. Very early.
So this might be our first do-it-yourself video.
Well, we also did the gas tank. The propane tank, I must say.
Mm. Yeah, that is true. And buttering up the RV.
Yes, we did do some things.
So, what did you say? Shall we do it?
Okie dokie. But
if it doesn't work, we have to call Herman.
Yes.
Mm. Petra is cleaning the battery. Meanwhile, for the two men out there, we also have a toolbox. Show them my toolbox. I mean, isn't this the most cute toolbox you ever seen? Mm-hmm. And it's filled with
tools.
Hand me a screwdriver. Always wanted to say that. Petra, hand me a screwdriver. That's the wrong one. I need a what's it called? I need a flat one. Yes, thank you. Usually I supervise work, but we'll see. You'll probably end up with me filming and Petra doing the hard labor.
Lefty Lucy.
What?
Lefty Lucy.
Yes, you American buddies learned us lefty loosey, righty tighty. So we're finally applying what we learned.
Lefty loosey. So. Now it's loose, you can just do it by hand.
Do we remember the order which to screw it back on? Oh, just capsized the battery. This is the plus connection. This is the minus connection.
Mm-hmm.
And we're just gonna, what's on here, we're gonna put on there. Mm-hmm. And what's on this, we're gonna put on that. As you can see, can we move the key? This screw needs to be loosened, but it's very close to this connection. And this side too, it looks like on the wrong side. So, but what do I know? So, now we'll figure out how to get the screw loose.
The screw loose? Well, this is a novel sight.
So, buddies, I bent this with my human power. And then I managed to get this thing on there. Wow. I just bent this backwards a bit.
Awesome.
And now I can...
Patrick the mechanic.
Already hand screw...
It loose.
The screw loose.
Well, this is awesome.
I mean, I think I missed my calling here.
Mm-hmm.
And my toy hammer. Oh, look, it's already coming off. Ta-da!
Ta-da! So that was the positive side?
This is the, yes, you can see here.
Plus.
If I clean off the dust, you see a plus.
Wow, a big plus.
I'm supervising while Petra does the other side.
Yes, I have smaller fingers.
Lefty Lucy.
Lefty Lucy.
I was turning it righty tighty.
Oh, I did it.
And it's loose.
And it's loose. Mm-hmm.
And then wedge it off. Maybe it's already
loose.
So that's the old battery out, and this one will replace it. This is the hole it left.
Yep.
Well, Petra is cleaning out all the piepschuim dingen. What's piepschuim? Foam? Squeaky foam. You can see the minus is a big round thing here, and the plus two, and here it's thin square ones. So we have to see if we can just connect those two. So in the old battery, the positive is on this side, and then the new battery, the positive is on this side, which would be on the old battery, this place. So, and the connections are in the front. So on the old one on the front, but if I put this in the same way, then the connections would have to be here. And I don't know if they're long enough to go to there. So the wise thing here is just to not worry about getting it in back in the box, getting the bunny back into the box, into the basket. But we're just going to connect it and just leave it out there and see what happens.
Working again.
Yeah, see if it does anything at all.
Mm-hmm.
Should I connect the red to the red first, and then the black to the black? So the charged with the charged, and then the black to the black, later, or should I do the black first, connect the charged translator, which might give a spark in theory. I don't know, just using logical. We're just gonna go with reds first, and then that's no problem, and then you connect the black, and then it won't give a spark or an explosion. In theory. Yeah, do you agree with that logic?
Can we Google that first?
Now let's go ahead. Famous last words. Let's just go ahead with it. So this was on the outside. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to put it on the inside because we have some extra room. Mm-hmm. I don't know if that... I don't think that can hurt. But I don't know. What do I know?
Yes. And this is the screw that was in the room.
What do you mean?
This was the original screw from this battery. And it has...
Oh, what is this? What am I screwing in here then?
That's the one that was on the old battery.
So Patreon, just film the awesome parts. Just a bit of my hand tight.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. Hey, I got parts left.
Uh-oh.
Not important, right? She's turning to the left.
Yes.
But from this side, she's turning to the right.
Yes. So,
that is confusing.
Very confusing.
Maybe some of the handy tool men out there can explain this.
Well, buddies, the moment of truth.
Yes, show them how we connected up the battery.
This way. Probably looks very amateuristic to some mechanics out there. But
so maybe somebody already sees the error and says don't turn it on. But we're gonna use the red key to turn it on.
Ooh.
This is a great moment in the series. It could be the last moment in the series.
Yes, it's very So it's connected.
Let's try a light.
Let's try the light. It's working. Awesome. High five.
We fixed it. It was just changing out the battery.
It's not a pretty fix, but it works. Look, we got light again.
And we can use the water.
And use the water, finally. Oh, finally. That's so nice.
So if you connect up to the power pole, we should also have the display working again. Oh, it is working again, or not?
Let me see.
Display. So the light is burning.
Yep, the middle light is burning. Ah. High five.
This thumbs up is for Herman.
Yes.
And this thumbs up is for Gerard for donating us the battery.
Mm-hmm.
And actually Gerard deserves another thumbs up for donating the battery.
Mm-hmm.
And this is for Herman just for
telling us the other battery was dead.
Yeah, for measuring, letting us know the thing. And now Herman,
yes.
How are we going to get this into there?
Yes, exactly. The radio is not working.
What's the on? And then we have to turn it on with the on button. See?
Oh!
It's working.
It's working! Yeah, maybe the volume is too... Yeah, I hear something.
I don't hear anything.
But I do.
Oh.
Yippee! Just the volume was too soft. Let's test the sink. We're gonna test the water pump. We're gonna lift this one up. Yay! Awesome! Look! Water! Water! Penelope's peeing. It's working.
Oh, wow. So this has another interesting question. If I would touch the positive now, would it give me a shock? Or is it safe to touch? So if anybody knows that, let us know. And then just find out that this my chair only goes to 120 kilos. So need anything? Second project of the day.
In order that the curtains don't touch the battery, in case of sparks.
Yes, we're shortening the curtains so it won't burn up when the battery spark.
Doga,
it's
Doga,
I, Prince
Pet, Doga.
Asking for the hand of Princess Petra.
I accept.
The end result.
The end result?
This way the curtain will not hit the battery, which is a safer thought for the night. Moment to show you the construction. As you can see, it's very firm. This doesn't open, and we don't know why, but it doesn't open, but it does makes it extra sturdy. Maybe that's the reason. And this is what we do. This way it's a couch, and then now it's a bed again. On to the next project. Cleaning the
pillows.
These are the pillows, as you can see, they're still from the
previous
owner. And yeah, they already been covered once. We have to find a fabricator. But it would be nicer if we would have a couch in that direction, and that it could pull out into a bed. So a couch against that wall, and then a pull-out couch that you can pull up and out into a bed, and then this could be a huge working area somehow. Or at least some working area in which Petra can go to sleep and I can still work. But if the couch is there, then you have much more inner room, and we could work with like a portable table, a foldable table.
I could sleep on the couch when it's folded up, and then you can work on the other side.
Yeah, that's what we're looking for, a way where Peter can sleep and I very unromantically can work on the laptop. Because I like to write at night, and these past few months I did not write much at all. I wanted to write another book this year and another poetry book, and I wanted to write the Pen and Pets Guide to the universe, to the RV universe. But when Petra goes to sleep, usually I'm just starting to wake up, wide awake. We would love to upgrade Penelope, and if an upgrade could include a way that I could write and Petra could sleep, that couch would be a great option. Possibly even get rid of this, and I'm talking future, that this is an old electric stove, and it's
nice pillow.
It's clean.
It's clean.
Yeah.
Sort of. As good as it gets.
Okay. this is an old electric stove, and we never use it because it drains too much power on the campsites. So this whole thing could go out, and that would make room for a possible working table, or even another couch, or something like that. I don't know. Ideas, ideas, ideas. Now we have power. Power. But the battery okay, it says. Can turn on these lights, as you can see. The load on battery light does not work, and the battery charging light also is not working. So,
is it charging again?
I don't think it's charging.
No, I believe Gerard said that it was already full, so it doesn't need to be. I need that below, which one you're sitting on.
So to know for sure if the battery will, because now we're plugged into power, and if the battery is full and topped off, it won't show the loading light.
No.
But it also didn't show the load on battery light, but it could start burning when the lights are on longer. And if the battery drains, and then see if the light of the charging battery will start burning. Otherwise, we know that will be, that is the problem, the loading. This one also drains and it doesn't get recharged, then there is a problem in the recharging connections. So the next project.
Giving it some making the door run smoother.
Yes, the door was not going open smooth. Whoa. So?
Yes. Just, yeah. It's against squeakiness. It's everywhere. And here. Yes. And a bit here.
Yeah, it's going all the way over.
Yep.
And there.
Drops, so it goes a bit smoother.
What are you saying? Project 5 is getting fries?
Yeah.